and on the net with over 10 schools and hundreds of live and archived broadcasts at www.
Welcome to coverage of the 2015 PIHL Penguins Cup Playoffs, only here on the Management Science Associates Sports Network. The high school hockey playoffs at MSASports.net are sponsored in part by the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena, by Blade Runners, by S-Mark, by First Commonwealth Bank, by Carlo University, by UPMC Sports Medicine, by ProGrass, and by Management Science Associates.
Between the defending champion Peters Township Indians and the Butler Golden Tornado. Along with Mike Azadian, I'm Don Rebel. We welcome you to the Robert Morris University Sports Complex on Neville Island. The winner knows they will be playing the Canada McMillan Big Macs, the fourth seed, going all the way to the finals. Canada Mac, a 7-0 convincing victory over North Allegheny. Peters comes in the number two seed, having knocked off Upper St. Clair in round one. Butler, the sixth seed, upsetting Bethel Park in round one.
Yeah, Peters Township with a convincing 8-1 win over Upper St. Clair, game that I did. This team's got three lines, three sets of defensemen, four pretty good offensive defensemen, and a lot of guys can score. And they scored three goals in the final 1:27 of the second period, all within 27 seconds, to go up from 4-0 to 7-0. And their goalie, Tony Lejeune, only gave up one goal. They outshot Upper St. Clair 31-16. They were 2-for-8 in a power play quickly. Butler, 3-1 win over Bethel Park. You saw that game. Connor Scott and Trevor Gilliland scored in the second. Jonathan Fair scored. It was 3-0, and they seemed to easily handle Bethel Park.
And we are underway. The puck play deep into the Butler zone, kept in at the left point by Peters. Zach Gilarowski along the far boards, digging for it. The Indians, shot goes sailing wide of the Butler netminder. Clay Bachman between the pipes for the Golden Tornadoes, and Butler survives that first onslaught. They clear out. Over skating is Brady Cochran for the Indians, and now an offside call against Peters Township.
Zach Gilarowski, you just mentioned his name. He's their leading scorer. I mean, he's the kind of defenseman that teams love to have. He can move the puck from end to end. He's got a great, quick first step, and he's got a great release. When he gets the puck on his stick, it is off his stick that quick. He's the kind of guy that if he's at an open shot, he's going to put it on net. Look out for him. He is the guy that makes this team go.
Kyle Medore between the pipes for the Peters Township Indians. To our right, Indians out of their own zone. So a pair of 29s manning the nets in this contest. Campbell for Butler takes a hit from Kyle's brother Ryan Medore. Plays on in the Peters Township zone. Behind the net for the Indians, it's Amelio. Amelio smacks it away. Good forecheck there by Connor Scott for Butler. But now here come the Indians. Down the right wing side, hitting the brakes is Ben Mountain. Finds a trailer in the slot. A little soft backhander toward the cage. Never got to the net by Amelio. Good, it's a shot through the legs of Bachman, but it went wide. Pressure by Peters Township early. Comes to the point. Wyatt's shot missed everything. Rebound, Medore turns and blasts and shot it wide. Medore had the golden opportunity just moments ago. That went through Bachman's legs but trickled wide to the left post. Wyatt tries to skate up, keep it in, but Butler able to clear out. Now pressure on the Indians' Max Boss by Jonathan Fair. And it's dumped in by Amelio, and the Indians go on a line change. Sam Gross for the Butler Golden Tornado. Tried to go to Martin. Can't get it out of his zone. Fair has to come back and play it for Butler. Golden Tornado have it. They'll finally get it out. Martin gave it away at the Peters blue line. Butler gets it and knocks it in deep. Back for the Indians to play it. It is Jake Raymore. Plant can't clear. Fair from the right point shot. Hit a skate and goes wide. Kept in nicely by Butler's Chris Martin along the far boards. Now it's played out. Pushed ahead by Carbonero. Carbonero will knock it in deep. In the Butler zone, Jonathan Fair. Near boards to get the puck for Butler. Up to McCall, who will smack it in deep. Behind the net. Chance for the Golden Tornado. Quick shot, Medore, the save. Blocking that short side. Another good save by Medore. On a quick shot by Butler's Ben Rogers. Coming from that left faceoff circle. Rogers, good play along the far boards. Now it's finally kicked out of the zone by Raymore for the Indians. Cochran turns it over for Peters Township. Onto the stick of Sam Gross. He misfires on a pass for Dustin Davis. And in his own zone, it's Gilarowski for Peters Township. He's hung up in his own zone. Softly gets it over to Raymore. Indians play it out. Center red. Barnes knocks it down the skate and then blasts one on the net from the left point. Bachman gloves and holds on.
You know, you mentioned Medore, the goaltender. Him and Lejeune take turns. Medore had the shutout against Butler back on February 2nd. Gilarowski had two goals. Both Cochran brothers had a goal. And they were 2-for-6 on the power play on that game. And Medore with 26 saves in the shutout.
Butler plays it out of their own zone. Amelio off his skate has to go back in his own zone to retrieve. Being harassed by Trevor Gilliland, very solid player for Butler. Works both ends of the ice. Chris Campbell can't get it in the near zone of Peters Township, or of Butler, excuse me. There's a turning shot, Gilarowski blocked down by Gilliland. And now we have our first penalty coming up. Going to be on Peters Township, I believe.
Interesting, you know, Peters Township the favorite here, but they're well aware of this Butler team and how good they can be. And you don't want to be giving up early power plays to Butler.
Yeah, they won't. It's the penalty is
on the
goal. Oh,
it's going to be on Butler? Okay.
My apologies.
That happens.
Gavin Morrison to the sin bin. No score early in this one. Peters Township and Butler. Winner against Cannon McMillan Saturday evening at the Consol Energy Center on MSA Sports. Morrison guilty of high sticking. Butler able to clear. And it's Ekberg for Peters Township. Carter Ekberg skating through the zone. Nice play down the right wing side around a man. Ekberg in too far though, and puck knocked off his stick by the last defense for Butler. Gilarowski, left point. Shot goes sailing wide from the near boards by Sam Barnes. Now with it, Alevi goes to the right point. Now Gilarowski to left point. And it's poke checked away. Look out. Here comes Davis. 2-on-1 shorthanded. Davis, wrist shot upstairs. Save is made by Madore, and it's cleared away by Peters.
Yeah, nice clear. Gilarowski got back there and got the rebound.
Alevi into the Butler zone, hits the brakes, looks for a trailer. Gilarowski at the left point. Right side, Gilarowski off the pass from Carter Ekberg, misfires, and again comes out of the zone. Gilarowski has to play it. Ekberg to Alevi. And he turns it over, and it's cleared by Butler.
Two right-hand shots on defense, Ekberg and Gilarowski, the two very good offensive players for defensemen.
Butler survives. Penalty is over. So they, the Indians of Peters Township 0-for-1 with the man advantage in this one. Along the near boards, Wyatt avoids a check by Scott, gives it up to Fair, though. Fair for Butler to Scott, wanted to go back to Fair, who had been knocked down off the play. Cochran for Peters Township into the Butler zone. He turns it over. Cleared by Connor Scott. Now Wyatt for Peters Township across the line. Big blast glove by Bachman, and he holds on.
Yeah, both goaltenders have been tested, and both goaltenders have come up big, and it's the early feeling out process in that first 5 to 7 minutes. Peters Township's fine to grind out a game and win 2-1. And I think that if Butler's going to win this game, it's going to have to be low scoring. Peters Township would like to get a little bit more on the scoreboard. They average 4.6 goals per game and give up a little less than 2 goals a game. They've given up only 45 on the year, scored 106. That's counting playoff games. Butler, on the other hand, they've scored 89. They've scored 3.86 goals a game, but they've given up 73. Give up over a little bit over 3 goals per game. They're 3-3 in their last 6. 4-1-1 is Peters Township in their last 6.
Wyatt shot from the left point goes wide after a faceoff win by Peters Township. Knocked in by Big Ben Mountain behind the Golden Tornado net. Look out. Here comes Emilio with it for Peters. Behind the net. Makes a move. Avoids a check. Gets it over to Ryan Madore. Amelia now goes right point, blast shot, never got to the net, knocked down. Butler unable to clear. Amelia again sails it wide of the cage. Wyatt fires, and that went wide, sticked by Bachman just in case. And again, the Golden Tornado just happy to get it out. Mountain misfires on his pass to fellow defender Max Boss, who has to go back behind his net to get it. And he turns it over. Campbell from behind. Morrison knocked down. Penalty coming up on Peters Township.
Ladies and gentlemen, MSA Sports Network.
Yeah, that's going to be the first power play for Butler. Speaking of power plays against Bethel Park, they were 0-for-2, and they killed 4 or 5 penalties. They were outshot against the Blackhawks 26-20, but Bachman made 25 saves. It was a big reason they won that game. Now it's Madore's turn to try to come up big.
Face off, won by Peters. They clear out of their own zone. Jake Raymore sends it deep. Good side placement over there, right?
I like it. Glass.
We were never able to do that before. Davis in the power play for Butler. To Gilliland, to Scott, all in the near boards. Fair center point shot went wide. Now Dustin Davis, far boards, comes to the faceoff circle. His shot saved by Madore. Gilliland with it, fakes a shot. Goes back near the far boards, looking. Looked like him and Davis were going to exchange places, but Gilliland stays along the far boards. Davis down by the goal mouth, tried to stuff it home. Save is made by Madore, and he'll hold on.
Yeah, he's been tested a couple of times. The one thing I really liked was Fair at the point. He did a great job. As soon as that puck on his stick, he got rid of it before the defense could catch up. Saved by Madore. That's the key. Get shots on net, create rebounds, create chances.
Face off to the right of Madure. Minute four left on the Butler man advantage, no score. Scott for the Golden Tornadoes, waits for the troops to come one side, drops it to Gilliland. Gilliland had the puck tied up in his skates. Trying to get it to Davis, look out, stolen away. Indians, Alavi shorthanded, twist turns, never got a shot off as it was blocked. Peter still has it though. Right point, Ekberg. Ekberg fires, good pad save by Bachman. Gilliland for Butler. To Alavi. Alavi fires and he missed everything. Power play is over, so both teams 0 for 1 with a man advantage. And now big hit. Sends Sam Gross down in the Peters Township zone. Indians trying to clear out. Sam Barnes along the far boards. Campbell keeps it in. Now it's taken by Carter Ekberg, and Ekberg will dump it out deep. And it'll be an icing call against Peters Township. 7:26 left here in period number one.
Follow us online for news, highlights, and fan interaction using our Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram accounts. Check your event program or visit PIHL.
No score, Butler and Peters Township.
Connect to the PIHL.
Well, both teams have had a power play, and both teams now 0 for 1 on the power play. Both goaltenders are looking strong so far.
Connor Scott on the dig for Butler, can't get it. And here come the Indians. Dumped in high and deep by Emilio. Behind the net of Butler. Digging forward is Madure. Now Scott. Cleared on. Past Max Boss, and it's an icing call against Butler. Thought Boss might have had a chance to play that puck. Not the case. Butler dumps it in deep. Madure steers it aside. First one there for the Golden Tornado. Chris Martin pays the price. Rubbed out of the play, and here come the Indians back. Martin for Butler. Dumps it behind the cage. Centered in front, nobody there. Now the puck played into the Butler zone. No score. The Golden Tornado. And the Peters Township Indians back in the Peters Township zone. To play it is Jake Rymore. Alavi. And he dumps it in deep behind the Butler net. Campbell now along the far boards. Can Marcus McCall get it out? He cannot. Kept in by the Indians. Alavi fires, and Bachman with a good save. Now rebound all the way out to the point. Kilarowski fires. Bachman with the save, and he holds on. Not sure. I think they might have called it offside, saying that puck came out of the zone before Kilarowski pulled the trigger.
Yeah, but boy, Kilarowski has one heck of a shot, and he is not afraid to pull the trigger. He's going to be on the ice every other shift, and younger brother, the leading scorer for the Peters Township B squad. For the Galarowski boys, one plays in Division II, the other one plays in AAA. Peters Township, one of a couple of teams that have two teams in the PIHL.
Yeah, the B team's still alive too, aren't they?
No, they're done. They lost to Indiana. Oh, no.
They didn't play Indiana.
That's right. They're still alive. You're right.
That's tomorrow on the network.
You're all right about that. Sorry
Peters
about that.
Township B team against the Little Indians of Indiana, a quarterfinals matchup. Morrison for Butler. Goes around a man, puck dumped behind the Butler net, or the Peters Township net. Morrison can't get it. Nice play there defensively. Carter Ekberg pulls the trigger up to Emilio. Emilio flying into the Butler zone. Goes wide, knocked off the puck, and a penalty coming up.
Well, what happens now is the speed of Peters Township, they took advantage of a light Upper St. Clair bench last week. And they are so fast sometimes, the only thing you can do is hook, clutch, grab. And if the referees are going to call the rule book like it should be, Butler could be in some trouble because Peters Township, at least one great skater on every line and at least one good skating defenseman, you got to pick your battle. So you got to find a way to get him off the puck.
A trip puts the Indians back in the power play.
2 minutes for
bad angle shot by Alevi. Hit the side of the cage. Gilarowski, Alevi. Looking for somebody in front. Now he goes to the defenseman coming up from the right point. Carter Ekberger pulls the trigger from the right faceoff circle. Bachman the save, and he holds on.
Battle in front with a defenseman, Sam Gross. And Cochran, Brady Cochran, one of the top scorers.
Good contingency of fans from both these schools. Coming to Neville Island, one timer by Peters Township's
I think that was Adam Alevi.
Yeah, it was Alevi. Stopped by Bachman. Bachman with a save and another shot this time from the left point by Gilarowski. Comes to Ekberg on the right point. Looking. Tries to go down. Knocked away by the Golden Tornadoes. Sam Gross, and he's able to clear.
Well, Peters is getting their chances, but goaltender Bachman coming up big.
Alevi into the zone. Throws one to the cage. Stick to side by Bachman. McNeil cannot clear. Kept in right point. Indians. Gilarowski now working the right point. He had been on the left point. Him and Ekberg switch. Now Ekberg on the left point. Spin move along the board. Sam Barnes tried to go to Gilarowski, cheating in. Gilarowski, though, could not get a shot off, and the puck comes out of the zone. Butler's Marcus McCall tried to send it in deep, hit one of the officials, one of the linesmen. Now Alavi back into the Butler zone. 20 seconds left. Ekberg is shot, and a good save by Bachman. Smacks it out of midair with his stick away from the cage. In front, centering pass, unable to get a stick going. It was Alavi. Comes to Ekberg, left point. Alavi has it. Side of the cage, shot to Bachman. Makes the save. And he'll hold on with 11 seconds left on the power play.
That's been a pretty tight defensive period. Neither team with a lot of chances, but Peter's starting toward the end of this period because of the second power play, getting more chances. Putting more pucks on the net for Bachman, but he's been good at controlling the rebounds, and that's a big thing. If you're letting rebounds get right out there into the slot, you could have some trouble, but Bachman's kept everything in front of him.
Face off to the right of Bachman. Golden Tornado able to clear, so that might do it for the Indians' man advantage. Butler clears out, and here comes Campbell out of the penalty box, so the Indians now 0-2. With the man advantage. And Butler, a steal by McCall. Into the zone, bumped off the puck, gets it back, smacks it behind the Peters net. On the chase for the Golden Tornado is Gilliland. Gilliland pushes it back to Bardo, right point. Bardo fires, and it was redirected wide. Getting a stick on it, Ben Rogers. Rogers now has it far board, centering pass broken up, and here come the Indians. Emilio, he's had a busy first period. Into the zone. Puck knocked off his stick, so he smacks it behind the Butler net and avoids a big check by Gilliland. And Gilliland looked a little rattled after that miss. Gilliland's shaking up.
He's having problems getting on the bench. They got to help him on the bench.
He went for the big check and he missed and hit all boards. Scott now for Butler down the right wing side. That would be a huge loss. Scott fires and he scores. Counting from right to left on the ice. Beats Medora on the glove hand right above the pad. And Butler, after killing the penalty, takes a 1-0 lead.
Yeah, the main guy, one of their main guys goes down. Everybody's concerned, and we still got to play on, and they go down and score. And that is a big, big goal late in the period, and that is going to come at the 15-11 mark of period number one, and it'll be a 1-0 lead, and Butler keeps surprising.
The Butler goal scored by number 86, Connor Scott.
Scott, nice move to give himself an open area to shoot.
Number 88, Dustin Davis.
Instead of coming down the right wing side, shot over across the high slot. And rifles one back the other way. Caught Medore maybe leaning to his right. He was definitely moving to his right. And Butler draws first blood. Scott now again for the Golden Tornado. Into the Peters zone. Shot to the net, never got there. Knocked down by the Indians. Now Medore will come out and cover up the loose puck. A face-off in the Indian zone.
They have a defending champion down 1-0, and they had an easy time against Upper St. Clair, but now this Butler team, we'll talk a little bit more about them. They've been up and down all year, 12-8-3. They've had a couple of losing streaks, and they've lost to this team a couple of times, but playing well now, and they've got two periods now to try to hold this lead.
1 minute in a period. 1 minute.
In the Butler zone. Knocked behind the Golden Tornado net. Cameron Bartow for the Golden Tornado. Plays it back to the neutral zone. There it's Brady Cochran for Peters Township. Good wrist shot on goal. Bachman to save, and he covers up.
Well, now Bachman, again, made 25 saves against Bethel Park. He's going to have to come up big because Peters Township, the type of team that they're not going to go away. They're going to keep on bringing out lines of good skating and good shooting players, and their defense is going to put it on net too. They'll be patient. They're not in desperation mode yet, but he's got to be strong for them.
Wait, another penalty coming up. Looks like it's going to go against Butler, and
yep,
it will be. That's one thing the Golden Tornado cannot afford to do is keep giving Peters Township the power play.
And the fans don't like it, but in the last game they played, 6-0 as Peters Township won. They were 2-for-6 on the power play against them. So you give them enough opportunities, they're going to score goals. You don't have to score on every power play, but if you can score on one-third of them, 33% is a pretty good percentage for power plays.
This will carry over to period number two if they don't score in the next 28 seconds.
Number 14, Jonathan Fair.
Eckert blast. Through traffic. Bachman, the glove save. And he holds on.
The first period.
Well, Bachman seems to be seeing everything, and that's the key for goalies. Anytime you talk to a goalie, if I can see it, I can stop it. If it doesn't deflect, I got a chance.
Jonathan Fair took the penalty. Faceoff win by Butler. Can they clear out? Yes, they can. Gilarowski could not hold it in. 13 seconds left. One more chance if they hurry. Cochran throws it into the slot area, but unable to get a stick on it. It was Alavi. Gilarowski's shot goes sailing way wide of the cage. Davis for Butler. Tried to clear, lost his stick, and a break for Butler, and that the horn sounds soon thereafter, ending the first period. Done with one. It's the
shots in the first
Butler
period.
Golden Tornado 1, the Peters Township Indians nothing. It's the PIHL Penguin Cup semifinals, sponsored by Trim Total Media, here on the MSA Sports Network.
Visit J&J Distributing at www.jjdistributing.biz and check out one of their largest selections of Penguins game-worn jerseys from your favorite pens, past and present. Or call 724-752-1556.
J&J Distributing buys, sells, and trades some of hockey's most prized possessions, including the Penguins game-worn jerseys, Penguins practice jerseys, minor league jerseys, and new and game-used equipment. Browse their inventory today at www.jjdistributing.biz.
This is Adam Horner, and as promised last year, Josh Rountree is here to help promote Season 10 of the PIHL Power Play right here on the MSA Sports Network.
But after so many years of coverage, where can we turn for some great hockey wisdom that we haven't yet? How about the head coach of the Mighty Ducks, Gordon Bombay?
Let's have fun out there. Soft hands. You don't shoot the puck to your teammate. You sail it to him.
And don't forget the most important piece of advice ever given by our mentor, Hans.
Wear thick socks, Gordon.
Catch the PIHL Power Play every Wednesday night at 8 o'clock on msasports.net.
Don Rebel, Mike Azadian, back second period, shot on goal, saved by Bachman somehow. He was able to retrieve the rebound before the Indians could score the tiebreaker as they are on the power play starting period number two.
Yeah, the Peters players complaining a little bit because the net came off the moorings. Maybe a defenseman bumped it. You know, that happens sometimes. But the puck laid there in the crease for the longest time, and Cochran finally covered up. Or Bachman, I'm sorry, covered up.
Face-off won by Peters Township, thrown to the net, hit a skate, look out, good save, Bachman. Rebound, Bachman with another save. Oh, man, he stopped not only Sam Barnes point-blank, but Olave on the rebound. Oh. Now, we talked to Pat Hammonds, head coach of Butler, before, and he said that Bachman's never nervous. He's always ready, and he has been brilliant tonight so far. Barnes fires, hit his stick, goes wide for Peters Township. 35 seconds left in the man advantage steal. It's Dustin Davis for Butler. He dumps it in deep. It goes off on a line change. Marcus McCall coming late. Man off the bench, can't Gilliland. But he couldn't tee it up. Good defensive play there by the Indians' Olave. Reached between the legs and smacked that puck away from Gilliland, who was about to fire from the right faceoff circle. Good to see him out there. He took a nasty hit against the boards in the first period. Power play over. Indians 0 for 3 now. With the puck, though, for the Indians is Gilarowski. Fires to the net. Saved by Bachman. Rebound. High slot shot. And again, Bachman with a left pad save. That time on the Indians, Carter Ekberg.
Well, Peters Township comes in droves, man. They just get that puck at center ice, dump it right back in, change lines, and go right back at it.
Seth Queen takes a hit, trying to clear it out, cannot. Campbell now for Butler in his own zone. Throws it behind the net. Both Queen and Fair over. Neither of them can get it out. Puck's loose in the doorstep. Look out. Wyatt fires. Save is made. Off a deflection. Rebound covered by Bachman, and he holds on.
And see, that's the thing. You know, Bachman can be there to make the saves, and but when you keep firing enough pucks, you're going to get a deflection. You're going to get a rebound. Someone's going to be there. And Peters Township right now is just beating them to the puck. Beating them to the puck again and again and again, and Butler's got to find a way to clear the zone. You just cannot have the offensive team in your zone for 2 minutes at a time.
Shot from the left point after a face-off win by Peters. Chad Wyatt went wide. On the dig along the near boards. Golden Tornado hemmed in their own zone for a while here now. Finally get it back to the neutral zone. Max Boss for Peters, backhands it in deep. Gross can't play it. Fair will for Butler. Goes behind the net, and it comes out to Marcus McCall. Misfires on a pass to Davis. Davis is going to get it anyway in the Peters zone. Davis goes behind the net, centered in front. Unable to get a stick on it. It was Ben Rogers in the slot. Peters able to clear out. Davis, though, for Butler, gets it over to McCall. One on two, can't squeeze between the two defenders. Rogers looking for a loose puck, can't get it. Back to the neutral zone, it's Sam Gross. fires it in deep. Scott will be the first one there for Butler to get it. He's rubbed off the puck on a hit by Chad Wyatt. Along the near side, turnover, Gross has it, fires, and he just missed near side. Rebound, oh! Net came off its moorings as Ryan Redman was getting ready to crank one up for the Golden Tornado.
Robert Morris Connection, we are at the home of the Robert Morris Colonials hockey team, but the Robert Morris Colonials basketball team has just won, and they are going to make the NCAA tournament, and that is the future home of Maddie McConnell, we just covered this past weekend. Congratulations to Robert Morris basketball.
Well, there'll be one local team.
Yep.
In the big dance this
unless
year.
Unless Duquesne or Pitt win the tournament. Win their own tournament, I mean. And that courtesy Dave McBain, by the way, one of your favorite athletic directors.
Puck at center red, whiffing on the dumping was Raymore, and now Butler able to dump it in deep in the Peters zone. 1-0 Golden Tornado lead, second period. Just under 13 minutes remaining in period number two.
Well, Butler withstood a real big Peters push early. Now they're starting to make a push of their own, winning some battles, dumping the puck, and controlling.
Bardo tried to get it to Axelson. He couldn't handle a pass. Now Axelson has it. Goes over to Chris Martin. Martin shot. Steered aside by Madure, and Peters clears. Long dump in by Weaver. On the bounce. Glove by Bachman, and he'll hold on.
You know, a lot of people thought that North Allegheny and Peters Township, a lot of people thought the 1 and 2 seeds, even middle of the year, they seemed to be head and shoulders above everybody else. North Allegheny going down now. I think Butler sees that. They're in the stands ahead of time. They see what happened. Maybe that inspired them a little bit. It wouldn't be something if the 1 and 2 seeds both get knocked out.
And other fans.
Face off won by Peters Township. Shot by Gilarowski from the top of the left face-off circle into the chest of Bachman. Again, he holds on. Not a whole lot of rebounds. Sign of a good netminder. Gross tries to clear it around the boards and does get it past Ekberg. Rogers on the chase. Giveaway almost behind the Peters Township net. Rogers does get it. Tried to throw it in front to McCall. Broken up nicely by Alavi for Peters Township. Now pass to Alavi, misfires, and here come the Golden Tornado back the other way. Shot, right faceoff circle by Rogers, and a good save by Madure.
Yeah, kept his left pad out there, good position.
Here comes Barnes the other way for Peters Township. Looking, still as the puck threw it in front, nobody was home. Only one there, Ben Rogers, who softly plays it up toward the Peters Township end. Davis then harangues the Peters Township defenseman almost into a turnover. And it comes on goal where Madure holds on. That was Gilarowski who almost had his pocket picked.
You're right. The good news is Gilarowski is back. Isn't he the one that went down?
Yes.
Loopy getting the bench? I didn't notice him in the last few minutes, but he's out there now to take the faceoff.
He was on earlier.
Good to see he's okay.
Yep. Madure knocked off the puck for Peters Township as he crossed the Butler blue line. Still digging for it as the puck ends up in the near corner. Kicked by Queen to no avail. Madure has it. Madure tried to fire and turning in front, couldn't unleash the puck. Now Amelio has it. Pass over to Boss, who snuck in from the right point. Boss, bad angle shot. And Bachman doing a good job hovering that post, not giving him anything to shoot at, knocking it down with the right pad. Pressure by Peters Township. One of the Indians upended, no penalty called, and here come the Golden Tornado. Gavin Morrison over to Scott. Scott tries to get around Boss, does, but without the puck, he has to go get the puck. Him and Boss battle. To the right of Madure. Centering pass to the point by Butler goes all the way back into the Golden Tornado zone. Jonathan Fair for the Golden Tornado.
Interesting that Butler withstood Peters Township early's push, and they've kind of taken the main middle of this period and kind of taken over a little bit.
Bardo knocks it in deep. Ackleson on the chase for Butler. To Martin, try to go back to Ackleson. Instead, the puck goes on net where Medora makes the save and holds on.
You just kind of wonder whether Peters, with that big push early, couldn't score early in that second period, had their chances, but was withstood that already. Their goaltender, Bachman, has withstood it, and you just have a feeling Butler's pushing here a little bit. If they can get a second goal, that's going to make it really tough on Peters Township, because all of a sudden Butler's defense has started to play a little bit better here. They got their legs under them a little bit. The key is going to be toward the end of this second period. Butler, are they going to be strong enough? Are they going to be physically fit enough?
Oh, good save by Medor. Right pad on the big blast by McCall off the faceoff win for Butler. Wow. Medor's best save of the night. Now the Indians coming back. Carbonero trying to squeeze past Connor Scott. McCall has it behind his own net for Butler. Along the near boards, battle for it. 1-0, Butler leading. 9.5 left here in period number two. Fair clears out for the Golden Tornado. Now it's Ekberg for Peters into the zone. Smacked off the puck, but it came right to his teammate, Scott Polina, who fires on goal, and Bachman the save and he'll hold on.
Now, last 5 minutes, Peters Township will go get one shot. And it's covered up. No rebounds. They're not winning the battles in the corners. And Butler's able to clear where they couldn't do that at the end of the first, beginning of the second. So it's kind of a change as Butler's done a good job of limiting Peters Township's chances.
Face off to the left of Bachman. Won by Peters Township. Ekberg through traffic. Blocker glove save by the Butler netminder. Now it comes into the neutral zone. Gilliland tied up with Cochran. Still battling for the loose puck. Gillavi had it. Now Gilliland comes away with it. Look out, 1-on-1. Gilliland to the middle of the ice. Poke checked off his stick. Good defensive play there by Gilarowski. Right point. Queen keeps it in for a moment. Then he got smacked over the boards. Now Gillavi. Fans in the shot coming down. Still puck rolled toward the net. And Bachman had to make the save. A lot of times you'll see that, Mike, where a goalie's ready for a shot. And either the puck is fanned on or maybe just got a piece of it. It's more like a changeup in baseball, and he struggles to keep that puck out. That time, Bachman able to make the save.
Yeah, he did. Not only that, but Olavi just kept on going right into the net. And nowadays, these players are so bold, they skate right at the net. And if they bowl the goalie over, okay. But goalie's got to be able to hold his ground, and he did. But you're right. Sometimes that changeup, that fan shot, really fools a goaltender.
In the Butler zone, Golden Tornado able to get it out. Boss throws it right back in for Peters. Barto leaves it for Gross. And now it's Ackleson who will knock it deep in the Peters zone. On the chase, Martin. Butler does a nice job getting the pucks. Loose pucks early. In front with, as he was falling backward. Able to get a stick on a redirect, Chris Martin. And a good alert save by Kyle Medor to hold on. Martin was getting blasted to the ice, and he was still able to get a stick on him.
Yeah, this is a really, really important time here for Peters Township. They cannot afford to give up a goal. It's mid-second period now, all way to go, halfway to go in this game. But, you know, they're not. Their offense isn't clicking like it was in the first period where they had a lot of shots, a lot of opportunities. And now all of a sudden, again, Butler just seems to be beating Peters to the puck. And if they get a goal here, Peters Township's going to really have to press down too. If Peters gets the next goal, all of a sudden the pressure's on Butler again.
Golden Tornado as Davis is taken out of the play behind the Peters Township net. Along the near boards, played out by Peters, but Gross has it for Butler. Right back into the zone, but it was before Davis could get out of the zone offside against the Golden Tornado.
You know, we talked to Rick Tingle a little bit before the game, and the main problem with their team is they have so many players, they have to scratch some players. Early in the year, they kind of knew that they were going to have some guys sharing time or if they had some injuries. But now guys like Jace Cochran, who scored a goal, a couple goals early in this year. Rosso Pica, guys who contributed, are sitting down for big games, and that's hard on kids sometimes, but
when you're playing for a big program like that, you got to get used to that kind of stuff.
Indians systematically bring it out of their own zone. And it is Adam Malavi down the left wing side, a trailer in Barnes, but Barnes couldn't collect, broken up and cleared by Butler.
They could have had a 2-on-1 if that puck would have found, I'm not sure who that was, Gilliland, I believe.
Malavi gets it up to Cochran, Brady Cochran down the left wing side for Peters Township into the zone, throws it in front, unable to get a redirect, was Barnes right on the doorstep.
Well, I tell you what, too many open guys for Peters Township. Butler's defense, gotta watch.
Back in his own zone, Seth Queen. Off the boards, cannot get it out. Malavi keeps it in, allowing Peters to set up. Left point, big blast, and the save is made by Bachman off the Gilarowski rifle. Now Malavi has it. Malavi fires. Never got to the net, hit a body. Gilarowski, right point, keeps it in, at least momentarily. Now Butler clears.
Boy, Gilarowski's got a cannon. When he has time to set up, look out, man. You don't want to get in front of that shot. He's got a very tough shot.
Malavi down the left wing side. He's got room. Gilarowski coming late. Wrist shots upstairs. Save is made once again by Bachman. That might have shaken up the Butler netminder a little bit. Malavi, high slot, fires. Oh, wicked wrister just went wide. Bachman, I don't think he ever saw it either. Late reaction. In traffic from the left point. Shot by Carter Ekberg. Bachman says no as Peters Township applying big time pressure.
Oh man, I'm telling you, Gilarowski had the one shot from the left point, a blast. Then the second time he couldn't control the pass. It gave the defense and it gave Bachman time to get over. He did end up getting a high wrist shot, but the shot was going to the area that Bachman wasn't covering. If he controls that first, if he can control the, controls that first pass, he might have scored there. Usually he gets rid of it quickly, but that time he couldn't, and that was the difference in it being 1-0 to 1-1.
Faceoff win, Peters Township. Giovanni Carbonero pushes it to the net. Bachman save, and another faceoff to his right. Won by Peters Township. Left point shot, never got to the net. Hit a body and came back toward Wyatt, who had unleashed the shot at the left point. Now a scrum for the loose puck. It's going to be Carbonero. Back to Wyatt. Wyatt fires, and he missed the net with two Indians in front. Now on the chase for Peters Township. Jake Shops couldn't get it, and Butler able to get it out. Jonathan Fair for the Golden Tornado into the Peters zone. Fair stops, and a good save by Madura. Rebound hit the side of the net by Chris Martin. Some Butler fans thought it was a goal, but it hit the outside of the cage. Ackleson, good short pass to McCall. McCall into the zone. Again, going from left to right. Puck slid off his stick, couldn't get a shot off though. Behind the Peters net. 5:15 left here in the second period. 1-0 Butler. Knocked down by the Indians. Mountain, big Ben Mountain behind the net. Tried to throw it in front. Broken up by Butler. Sam Gross on the good defensive play. Now up to Dustin Davis. Davis into the Peters zone behind the net with speed. Leaves the puck, and the Indians will take over from there. Carter Ekberg tried to get it to Mountain coming out through the neutral zone. Broken up by Davis. Ekberg again has it into the Butler zone, and he's met at the blue line. And again, Davis doing a nice job on both ends of the ice. And now a penalty called against Peters Township.
Wow, that is not good for them. Who's going to go to the box? That's going to be Ben Mountain. This will be their second power play, one in the first period.
One by Butler, fair soft shot from the point, never got to the net. Knocked down by Gilarowski. Gilarowski comes to the Butler blue line, and he fires one that hits a stick. It goes over the ice and out of play. See where they have this face-off. They're going to put it right inside the Butler blue line.
This is huge, huge penalty kill for Peters Township. They cannot afford to go down 2-0 heading into the third period. And for Butler,
this possibly could be the game in this next 1 minute and 50 seconds. They get a power play goal here with the way that Bachman's playing, with the way that their defense is played. I'm sure Peters Township's going to have some more opportunities, but this is a very, very pivotal part of the game for both teams as the referees get together. And they changed, Don. They're going to take the face-off outside the blue line.
Only about 10 feet, but big difference inside the zone and outside the zone. Here come the Golden Tornado now with the power play. Scott, drop pass, Gilliland blast! Good save by Madore. Gilliland has it behind the net, tried to get it to McCall in front, could not. Now a lot of Butler Golden Tornado down deep in the zone. Got to be careful about that. Gilliland with the puck, throws it in front, could not hook up with Sam Gross coming across his right in front of the goal mouth.
Boy, Gilliland almost scored. Boy, I tell you one thing. Madore got down. That puck was headed for the 5-0. He got down just in time.
Knocked down from behind is Fair. Able to get it up to Davis. Davis wrist shot missed the net. Bardo now at the left point. Gives it away. Steal by Peters Township's Carter Ekberg. Dumps it back to the neutral zone. There is Jonathan Fair. Brings it into the Peters zone himself, wrist shot, and a good save by Madore with the right pad. And Peters able to clear out.
The referee was trying to explain to the head coach, Patrick Hammonds, that why he didn't make the calls. He was skating by, they were yelling at him, but no call on the hit from behind.
Gross for Butler into the Peters zone. 30 seconds left on the man advantage. Indians get it and clear out again. Down to 20 seconds left in the power play for Butler. Bardo in his own zone. As Rogers skates up himself, hits Davis. Hurry, if they hurry 2-on-1. Davis fakes a shot, goes wide. Now looking for teammates and just dumps it behind the Peters net.
Penalty over.
So both teams 0-for. As far as man advantage is concerned, an icing call against Butler with 2:33 left in the second.
You know, in hockey, there's so many factors. You have to have good goaltending to win. Your stars have to perform. You have to have solid defense. But sometimes a lot of people forget the team that does better on the special teams, killing penalties and scoring on the power play, most times is the team that comes away victorious. Both teams, again, like you just pointed out, 0-for. Almost every game I do, that is probably the deciding factor on teams that are even.
Indians out of their own zone. Gilliland takes over at center red. Good drop pass to Scott. Scott had a poke check off his stick as he entered the Peters zone. Nice play there by Gavin Rebholz for the Indians. Now one of the Golden Tornadoes. Scott knocked down outside the zone. Long shot from nearly center red by Peters Township. Bachman to save and not wanting to take any chances. Holds on with a minute 55 left.
Now Peters Township killed a penalty. That's important for them. And they go into the locker room down 1-0. They'll take that. They'd love to get a little bit of a push here. And with a faceoff in Butler's territory and a left-handed shot and Levy out there, he could shoot right off the faceoff. And he did. Wow. Big save. Sorry about that. I mean, it happened so fast, I figured, you know. That was huge, Don. I've seen that a lot this year. I'm sure you have, where a left-handed shot coming from the left side will take the faceoff and shoot and try to shoot instead of trying to draw it back. I've seen goals scored that way this year. And I know you have too, and that's what Levy did. I was explaining it. Next thing you know, they dropped the puck, and I'm not sure that Bachman even saw it.
Well, here's a right-handed shooter, Barnes, taking it from the right-handed face-off circle.
It's a strategy. It might not work 15 times in a row, but then the one time it does.
I have not seen a goal scored that way, but that's all right.
I've seen a couple this year.
Puck played out of the Butler zone.
Mary Lemieux used to do that.
Yeah.
That's where people got it from.
He used to do a lot of things.
Yeah. Boy, do I miss seeing him play, huh?
Oof. Puck played into the Peters Township zone. Peters Township bench area. Rick Tingle The head coach of the Indians with the right-hand save.
Boom. Yeah, nice.
Huh?
Three assistants on the bench. Full. Mike Antonucci, Cliff Bumford, and Ryan Tingle on the bench with him. And for Butler, with Patrick Hammonds, Ian Hammonds, Corey Sikalski, and Ben Morrow. All the coaches.
Ekberg for Peters Township enters the Butler zone and gave it away. Scott could not clear, though. Indians have it. Near and a minute left, second period. Unable to control his Barnes for the Indians, and here come the Golden Tornado. Bardo could not hit Scott. Alavi has
1 minute remaining
into the zone. Alavi for Peters Township fires, and it just went wide. Again, that move where you're going left and you have that netminder move and you try to go back to the far side. Butler dumps it in deep. Oh, look at Medor. Way out of his cage. Look out. Bardo has it. He can't shoot. Now a follow-up shot by Fair. And what a glove save by Medor as he was back on his hind side.
Boy, remember that. Boy, Bardo came in. He skated right over the puck. If he's able to get that puck, it's a wide open net. All he has to do is throw it to the net, and it's 2-0. Oh, man, Medor came out, but a quick Butler forecheck got in and caused problems. Man, you've got to be careful as a goaltender. You've got to be absolutely sure you're going to beat the man to the puck.
Yep.
That could have been costly.
But he redeemed himself with a big glove save. Unfair. Now one of the Indians gets his helmet knocked off. Big check by Jonathan Fair. And Ben Mountain loses his helmet.
Man, it's going to be a penalty. We're going to get an elbowing call. And I think that's against Butler.
Yep.
Interesting. And I cannot remember that referee's name. And I don't know if it's on the sheet here. But that, I have just been informed, is the ex-Beaver Bobcat coach. Still not sure what happened, but some controversy down in Beaver, and they're going to go to the semifinals without their coach that's been their coach for at least the last 5 or 6 years.
The Butler penalty box door is open. Campbell is talking to the officials. Chris Campbell.
I thought they were going to maybe take two, but are we going to get anybody? Campbell's going to go over and talk to the bench and see what happens. Somebody's going to go.
They got the door open.
He's going to go talk to the coach now, Campbell is. And everybody waits. Yep, we're going to see Jonathan Farragut, second penalty on him. He's not happy. Fourth power play for Peters Township. You can't keep giving a team this good, this many opportunities. Well,
like they did in the end of the first period. This will carry over if the Indians do not score. Alavi can't control. Cleared out by Butler. Ekberg goes cross ice. Gilarowski, and again, the Indians lose the puck, and Butler clears. Maybe time for one last rush with 6 seconds left. Long dumping into the Butler zone. Gross has it. And Gross will just carry it behind the net. And Butler will go into the locker room up one in this semifinal contest. End of two periods. It's the Butler Golden Tornado 1. The Peters Township Indians 0. You're listening and watching the 2015 PIHL Penguin Cup Semifinals. Sponsored by Trib Total Media here on the MSA Sports Network.
Want to learn how to ice skate or play hockey like they do in the PIHL? Looking for a good place to throw that winter birthday party? If you answered yes, Blade Runners is the place to go for public or private skating sessions, plus learn to skate and learn to play hockey classes. And don't forget to check out PIHL game action at their two locations in Harmerville and Warrendale. For more information on ice time, class and game schedules, or party planning, visit their website at www.bladerunnersice.com. See you at the rink. Attention all teenagers in the South Hills. If you need something to do on a Friday night, look no further than the TGIF Skate at the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena. Featuring a live DJ, big screen TV, special effects lighting, and games from 8 to 11, it's the place to be this winter. Mount Lebanon Ice Arena also offers an after-school skate for younger children, Fridays from 4:30 to 6 p.m., and a full range of instructional programs for all ages. For more information, call 412-561-4363 or visit mountlebanon.org.
The team at S-Mark takes great pride in the company they've built and their growing presence in Pittsburgh. Strong values, steadfast dedication, and unwavering commitment extends well beyond the walls of S-Mark facilities into virtually every facet of our local communities. From ongoing support for critical health and human services for families and children to youth sports and recreation programs, it's the many faces of S-Mark that touch lives, instill hope, and provide opportunities to enhance and enrich the world around us. S-Mark is proud to extend its support of local communities through its sports sponsorship with the MSA Sports Network.
The history books are filled with the names of great athletes and great teams from Western Pennsylvania. They share stories of great victories and stunning defeats, but they all have one thing in common. They know the championship season is the time to be first. First Commonwealth Bank, proud sponsor of the WPIAL and the best high school athletes in Western Pennsylvania. First Commonwealth, time to be first.
Life is about having the confidence to know you can do anything, right? I get that at Carlo.
I graduated with top awards, but beyond the classroom, Carlo helped me learn a lot about myself.
Carlo brings out the best in you.
I know I'm going to be a fantastic nurse.
I know whatever I come across, I'll be prepared.
I can't think of a better place to start the rest of my life, because at Carlo, I know I matter.
I matter.
I matter.
Enroll at Carlo University. Visit carlo.edu.
UPMC Sports Medicine is the region's largest and most experienced center dedicated to caring for athletes of all levels. And as we celebrate more than 25 years of world-class care, we're proud to offer more services, have more physicians, and treat more student athletes than any other sports medicine provider in the region. Why would you choose to go anywhere else? To learn more, call 1-855-93-SPORT or visit upmcsportsmedicine.com.
Dawn Rebel, Mike Azadian at the Robert Morris University Sports Complex. 1-0 Butler leads Peters Township after two periods in this semifinal matchup. The winner to play Canna McMillan, the Big Macs, earlier today. A 7-0 whitewash of the top seed, the North Allegheny Tigers. AAA has been... It has been the classification, Mike, including most of this year, the classification of parity.
That's a good point.
Quaker Valley, Mars, those two have dominated the Class A program. Those two alone have won the last 7 championships. Double A, Latrobe had a run of 3 in a row. Bishop Canavan has won 2 of the last 4. But AAA, 6 different winners over the last 6 years. Peters Township, the defending champion. North Allegheny won it 2 years ago. Bethel Park in 2012. Upper St. Clair in 2011. Canna McMillan 2010. Shaler in 2009. And Pine Richland in 2008. So for that streak to continue, Butler would have to win it all. And
yeah.
They could.
They could. And, you know, Cannon Mack is already going to be back in for the first time. Well, they're going to have a chance to win it for the first time since 2010.
But you're right. For a long time, 2000 to 2002, Bethel Park had won three in a row and had won four out of six, actually five out of eight, and dominated for a long time, as Meadville did too. But, yeah, in the last 8-9 years, it's been parity, which you like to see. Nobody wants to see the same team win all the time. It's nice to see new blood. Nothing against Peter's Township, but, boy, if Butler can win this, it's going to be exciting. And Butler County proud. A lot of people from Butler County here tonight, and they're hoping to make the trek to Console on Saturday night.
MSA Sports will be video streaming and audio streaming all three Penguin Cup championships. On Saturday at the Console Energy Center. O'clock for the AA title game, 7:15 for AAA, 9:30 for Class A. All three Penguin Cup finals at MSASports.net. Well, Mike, your job is very easy.
Yeah, it is.
Blade Runner scoring summary through two periods. Blade Runner's two locations, Warrendale and Harmerville.
Well, scoring only one goal, and it was in the first period. Butler, Connor Scott scored at 15-16 late in the first period, assisted by Dustin Davis and Jonathan Fair, and led 1-0 after one. No scoring in period two. Shots on goal, Butler has 15, Peters Township 32, so they're doubling up on shots. Peters Township is 0 for 3 on the power play. They are in the midst of their, wait a minute. Did they take the penalty down off the board, or they still,
there's still time left.
Still time left on the penalty. So they are 0 for 3 and in the midst of their fourth power play. Jonathan Fair has been called for two penalties for Butler. Christopher Campbell and Gavin Morrison as well. And Peters Township with two penalties against them, Matt Emilio and Ben Mountain. So Butler is 0-for-2 on the power play, and we'll have the scoring summary after the game, along with the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena play of the game. Mount Lebanon Ice Arena is the place to be for teams in the South Hills on Friday nights. And of course, the Management Science Associates 3 stars of the game. And that Blade Runner scoring summary brought to you by Blade Runners. There's two locations in Warrendale and Harmerville.
Both netminders have been challenged. Both netminders have come up big. Kyle Medor for Peters Township stopping all but one. Clay Bachman of Butler has been fantastic, stopping each and every shot unleashed by the red and white.
Yeah, and he's had a couple of times where he didn't see it and it hit him. The shot off the faceoff by Alavi. And there's been a couple of times where he didn't see shots from the point that just missed. But sometimes you got to be lucky as a goaltender. But he has had, he's come up big numerous times. He's done a very good job. And on the other side, Medor let one in. He made a mistake, but made up for it after he challenged one of the Butler forwards for the puck. But made up for it. That could have been disastrous. It could be 2-0. But both goaltenders have held their own here tonight. It's been a very good defensive game. But, boy, Peters is really piling up the shots. And if you give him another 16 shots, Don, well, I tell you what, it's hard for me to see them getting 45 to 50 shots and not denting the scoreboard. But if they do not, it's going to be a lot to do. Clay Bachman's going to be the guy.
Erie Cathedral Prep against Armstrong in the Class AA final. Cannon McMillan against the winner of this game in the AAA final. And tomorrow, the Class A championship game will be determined. The semifinals tomorrow night here at the Robert Morris University Sports Complex, 6 o'clock and 8 o'clock. Quaker Valley against Hempfield at 6 o'clock. Deer Lakes against Mars at 8 o'clock. We'll have both those games, audio and video, at msasports.net. Third period coming up. Butler leads Peters Township 1-0. It's the PIHL Penguin Cup semifinals, sponsored by Trib Total Media here on the MSA Sports Network.
Own your piece of hockey history with a Penguins game used jersey. Visit J&J Distributing at www.jjdistributing.biz and check out one of their largest selections of Penguins game worn jerseys from your favorite Pens, past and present. Or call 724-752-1556. J&J Distributing buys, sells, and trades some of hockey's most prized possessions, including the Penguins game-worn jerseys, Penguins practice jerseys, minor league jerseys, and new and game-used equipment. Browse their inventory today at www.jjdistributing.biz.
When looking to replace your athletic field, choose ProGrass, first in turf. ProGrass has installed over 500 fields in the U.S. Getting the best artificial turf for your field depends upon both the product and the partner you choose. That's why architects, athletic directors, and players choose the ProGrass Performance System. ProGrass maintains an active presence in the field turf industry as members of the Sports Turf Management Association and the American Sports Builder Association, and is proud to be recognized as a FIFA preferred manufacturer. Call ProGrass today at 866-270-6003 or visit them on the web at www.prograssturf.com. ProGrass, first in turf.
The team at S-Mark takes great pride in the company they've built and their growing presence in Pittsburgh. Strong values, steadfast dedication, and unwavering commitment extends well beyond the walls of S-Mark facilities into virtually every facet of our local communities. From ongoing support for critical health and human services for families and children to youth sports and recreation programs, it's the many faces of S-Mark that touch lives, instill hope, and provide opportunities to enhance and enrich the world around us. S-Mark is proud to extend its support of local communities through its sports sponsorship with the MSA Sports Network.
Hi, this is former Seton Hall Mount Pleasant Trinity basketball coach Joe Dunn. Here to tell you that I'll be joining Don Revel and Johnny Lee on the WPIL Round Ball Report Wednesday nights at 6 p.m. here on the MSA Sports Network. There we go.
Coach, this is a 30-second commercial.
What? Whose call was that? That's a terrible call. I mean, I just sat down here. I'm all, you know, this is the kind of stuff that happens to me.
We have another ex-coach.
You know, it's just one of those things.
Join us for the WPIL Round Ball Report Wednesday nights at 6 o'clock here on the MSA Sports Network.
The history books are filled with the names of great athletes and great teams from Western Pennsylvania. They share stories of great victories and stunning defeats, but they all have one thing in common. They know the championship season is the time to be first. First Commonwealth Bank, proud sponsor of the WPIAL and the best high school athletes in Western Pennsylvania. First Commonwealth, time to be first.
Don Rebel, Mike Azadian at RMU, getting ready for what should be a marvelous third period. A minute 30 left, power play time for Peters Township. They trail 1-0 as the Indians win the faceoff. Carter Ekberg dumps it in deep along the fresh sheet of ice. Alavi throws it in front. Davis broke it up for Butler. Then he had the puck knocked off his stick. Golden Tornado cannot clear. Alavi dumps it back. Ekberg, big blast. He missed the net. Thrown in front. Davis has it for Butler, and he clears.
Well, Peters Township definitely needs to get a couple pucks on net.
Medora comes out, plays it up to Alavi. Alavi goes behind the net, throw in front. Nobody there, and Gilliland able to clear.
Big key after that first shot. Somebody's got to win the battle and dump it.
40 seconds left on the man advantage. Cochran down the right wing side. Snapshot, hit a stick, goes wide. Off the end boards, Bachman then gloves it and holds on.
Well, for Butler, obviously the key is got to kill this penalty. I think another key is they cannot give Peters Township a couple of more
power plays. They're averaging two a period. They give them six. It's going to be really tough. Then they got to limit the shots. They can't give them 12, 15 shots. And they've got to find ways to control the action in Peters Township's territory. For Peters Township, they got to keep doing what they're doing. Firing pucks on net and somehow find a way to beat Boffman. We got a delay. We change some personnel as Chad Wyatt comes out on defense to pair with Gilarowski. Now Gilarowski's going to leave. Interesting. Oh, someone from Peters Township is going to the locker room. That looks like that's Carter Eckberg. Can't afford to lose him, so I don't know what's going on, but... And Max Boss comes out. Interesting change.
Face-off won by Butler, trying to crank it around the board. Sam Gross can't get it out. Gilliland then will push it ahead deep into the Peters zone.
By the time Eckberg walks all the way around the arena, gets to the locker room, and if he comes back, he's going to miss 5-6 minutes. He may miss a shift or two. That's huge.
Butler trying to knock it out deep, and they do get it back to the neutral zone. High stick of the puck, though. Against the Golden Tornadoes, see where they bring this face off. Were they going to say against Peters? Don't bring it into the Indian zone. That's not good. Power play, the Indians are going to be 0 for 4, 1 second left.
And another thing, too, remember the old adage, it's hard to beat a team three times in 1 year. They've already beaten them twice. As we mentioned earlier, they beat them 3-1 and at Peters Township, then at Butler 6-0. So the aggregate score of 9-1, and a little bit different here tonight.
Davis for Butler. To Fair, one of the Golden Tornado knocked down well behind the play. Nothing called. That was McCall by Mountain. Rogers with good pressure in the Peters Township zone for Butler. Turnover, Davis shot, hit a stick, goes wide. Now look out, almost came out in front. Medor was down to his knee trying to scoop it back into himself. He missed. But then on the second time around, was able to scoop it up.
Medor's got to be careful with that. Another split second, there's a Butler player right in the crease. Look out. You have to be careful. One little mistake in a tight game like this, a 1-0 game could cost your team a game. A goal by Butler here would really be a nail in the coffin maybe for Peters Township. But... fortunately for them, they just keep putting pucks on net. That's all they want to do is try to get something past Bachman.
Carter Eckberg back out there for Peters Township. Colina now dumps it in deep for the Indians. Nice job by Sam Gross to overtake his man, get the puck. Fair cannot clear for the Golden Tornado. Colina keeps it in. Colina has the puck roll off his stick. Now look out, Gerolowski has it center point. Gerolowski fires, and it went wide. Might have hit his stick. Good job by the Peters Township defenseman. Now look out, a backhand. Unable to really tee it up, though, was Carbonero. He had Bachman leading big time. Now Bachman down, thought he had it covered up. There is a whistle as the puck escaped his glove. He's watching Bachman come out to start the third period. He's taking a couple shots high. He's just acting a little gingerly maybe here in the third period, Michael.
Yeah, he took that one off his shoulder earlier that he didn't see. He's taking a couple of big ones off the chest. Maybe he's having some breathing problems. We'll find out.
Well, we hope it's nothing like that.
Yeah, I hope he's okay.
Gilarowski in his own zone for Peters Township. Misfires on the outlet to Cochran. It's going to be an icing call against Peters Township. Puck still rolling.
Nobody notices it. Some Peters
Rick
Township
fans. Rick Tingle did.
Yeah, Rick Tingle did. Now they're holding up action. They finally stopped, but they're going to have to put another 10 seconds at least back on the clock.
It was 10 seconds. It was 14:02 with the icing call.
You got one job to do.
Is that Chaussee down there?
I don't know. It could be. Maybe a Lee Moan or a...
maybe Matt Krasuski on the clock. We got 13:52. They're 13:57, so...
wow.
Keep that in mind. That's 5 lost seconds.
That's not good. Yeah, it's at least 5 seconds. Rick Tingle noticed it, but maybe...
I looked up as soon as the whistle blew. It was 14:02. And it kept ticking. Golden Tornado out of their own zone. Turn it over. Gilarowski turns it right back and smacks it deep behind the Butler net. There, Jonathan Fair, pretty solid hockey player. He misfires on an outlet pass to Davis. It's going to be icing against Butler.
You see, so many teams do this now where they try those long outlet passes from deep in their zone to forwards who are in the neutral zone that are almost at the red line. And a lot of times, it's they're past the red line. If you connect on them, great. You've got a two-on-one, maybe a breakaway. But you'll see that 8, 10, 12 times a game, and you may only hit on it once.
Right point shot by Ekberg. Knocked down, never got to the net. Ekberg now in the neutral zone. Turnover. Gilliland has it as he picked Alevi's candy. Now Cochran back with Peters Township down the left wing side. Cochran goes wide, rubbed out into the boards. Still was able to get it in front. No white jersey there. Ekberg tried to crank it from the right point. Smacked away by Connor Scott.
Butler's doing a good job of taking the forwards to the boards and not giving them room to create.
Another icing coming up.
Ladies and gentlemen, on Trip Butler. Total Media is one of the largest sources of news.
12:43 left third period, 1-0. Golden Tornado.
A lot of times on defense, if you just back in, you let the forwards do what they want. They're all coming to the net together, and they're there for rebounds. But if you take the forward to the boards, he's got a choice. He's got to go behind the net, or he's got to drop it back. But Butler's defense is limiting the forwards for Peters Township. Doing a good job.
Along the near boards in the Butler side. Puck hits off Martin, deflects out. Ackleson has it. He'll dump it in deep and go on the chase for Butler. Again, Ackleson got there, but nice job by Max Boss to tie up his stick. Here comes Ben Mountain. He smacks it in deep. A lot of dump and chase now for both teams. Knowing that the blue lines are clogged up, both teams doing a nice job. Martin. Dumps and chases for Butler. Goes behind the net. Stood up by Amelia. Now it's Ryan Medor, brother of goaltender Kyle. Twin brother, I believe. Davis pokes it ahead for Butler to Fair. Coming late down the right wing side. Jonathan Fair rubbed out by a pair of Peters Township Indians. Then a shot in front went wide, and Rogers literally tackled to the ice. Penalty coming up. A crank by the Golden Tornadoes' Marcus McCall, gloved by Kyle Medor, but power play forthcoming for the Golden Tornado.
This might be Emilio.
Whoever it was a pretty good open field tackle.
Yeah, and you know, again now, Butler with another chance to go up 2-0, and that would look pretty good, even though there's 11 minutes to go. I can't see who that is, but we'll find out.
Face off won by Butler. Fair, with the right point shot knocked out.
2 minutes for a hold.
Short-handed, Carbonero can't get the pass.
Of the third period.
From Gilarowski. Now Cochran. Back to Ekberg. Gives it away. Gilliland for Butler into the zone. Gilliland fires and he shot it over the crossbar. Davis can't keep it in the left point for Butler. Who was the penalty on?
That was on Gavin Redholtz.
All right. Davis for Butler, down the left wing side, goes to his backhand, fires at the side of the outside of the cage. Indians have it and clear. Short-handed, it's Alavi down the left wing side, one-on-one, tries to get around the defender, puck comes to the net.
Ladies and gentlemen,
gloved by Bachman, and he'll hold on.
North University Sports Management Association.
Yeah, boy, I tell you one thing, Alavi comes down, tries to do that. Move. If he makes it around her, he's going to have a one-on-one. But the defense, again, the defense of Butler had come up big time and time again. They have not allowed any odd man breaks. I can't remember Peters Township having an odd man break. No two-on-ones, no three-on-twos. Butler's defense, the forwards, they're getting back. They're quick line changes. Notice they're all standing up on their bench, where Peters Township's all sitting down. That's another interesting little tidbit.
Well, this has been there, done that for Peters Township, defending champs. This is breaking ground for the Butler Golden Tornado Club. Down the right wing side, shorthanded. It'll go. Look at it. Went through the goal mouth. Whew. Unable to pull the trigger was Alavi. Just rolled off his stick and went right across the goal mouth.
He's shorthanded, too.
And again, Bachman, he just looks a little out of sorts. Alavi has it again. A wrist shot goes sailing wide. All Peters Township now. Long shot on goal. Save is made. Rebound unable to tee it up as Barnes. Golden Tornadoes have it. 15 seconds left on the man advantage. It's Scott. His shot hit a stick, goes wide. Try to center. No blue jerseys around. And an easy clear for Peters. 5 seconds left. Maybe one more shot. Here comes Davis. No, offside against the Golden Tornado as time expires on the Red Bulls penalty.
You know, Levy did everything but score on that last shift. Well, he came down the right side, made a move on the defenseman, was dragging the defenseman with him, went through the crease. And you say he just, whether his stick was being held, he just couldn't get rid of it. But you're right. Bachman just didn't move. And it's almost like he waited to the last second. All Levy had to do was get a stick on it, and he probably puts it in the net, and Bachman didn't react to it at all.
McCall for the Golden Tornado. Wrist shot may have been sailing wide, but Medore gloves it nonetheless and holds on with 9:18 left.
The Class AAA final starts at 7:15 p.m.
And this year they're going to play the AAA final at 7:15 p.m. For a lot of years, the AAA game goes really late, sometimes doesn't end at 11:30, 12 o'clock, and they decided that the bigger schools are going to get a primetime opportunity and have a game played where it's not going to end very late.
Like midnight.
Exactly.
Fair turns around for Butler deep in his own zone. A miss pass sends Wyatt back in his own zone for Peters Township. Now they're going to call icing against the Golden Tornado. A lot of whistles. Both these netminders have done a nice job, Bachman and Medore, of covering up anytime that puck gets near them. So not a whole lot of second or third opportunities for either team all night long.
And you're right, except for a couple of minute stretches where Peters Township had in the first period. At the end of the second period, they did, but since that time, they really haven't.
Barnes into the zone, left wing side. Good snapshot and a better save by Bachman. And the puck played out by Butler.
Another thing is the forwards for Butler come out to the points, too, to stop the defenseman from shooting for Peters Township, which is a big part of their game.
Down the right wing side, wrist shot. Bachman with a good save, denying Carter Ekberg, who took off from his right point. Coming down from the right faceoff circle. Alavi goes to the side of the net. In front shot by Barnes, and the save by Bachman. Barnes couldn't tee up the rebound. Alavi shot from the high slot, hit a skate, and finally cleared out to the neutral zone. This line, Alavi, Cochran, and Barnes dominating right now.
Yeah, they were getting to every loose puck.
Here comes Davis back for Butler, one on two. Davis tries to split the defense. He is knocked off the puck, which rolls slowly to Kyle Medore, who covers up.
It's unlike Peters Township, just not to get any goals, but getting a ton of shots. And you got to credit Bachman, who has looked a little shaky at times, but I think he's back on now. A couple of big saves. That blocker save was huge.
Campbell for Butler, right point, through a bunch of skates. Somehow got on the net. A good save by Medore. That was some heavy traffic in front of the Peters netminder. Innocent shot by Campbell, but somehow got through. And Medore makes the save. Scott in front, man there, back and score! Ben Rogers, they forgot about him behind the play, and when Butler was able to keep it in, Rogers snuck in front of the net, took the pass, and went upstairs to beat Medore stick side, and the Golden Tornado lead 2-0.
And they're getting outshot this period. Again, unofficially, I'm not positive. I'm trying to keep track, but I think it's like 10-3, 10-4. Severely getting outshot. But 2-0 lead.
The Butler goal scored by number 63, Benjamin Rogers.
Well, that's a heck of a shot by Rogers. Hard to fault Madure. It's 101 there. Peters comes back. Shot by Emilio. Knocked on. 101. It was just a tremendous shot. Backhander underneath the crossbar and in. Maybe even off the crossbar and in. 2-0 Butler.
And Peters Township has not been shut out this year. And they've been held to one goal twice, once against North Allegheny in a loss, and once against Seneca Valley in a loss. Not been shut out all year long. A team that averages 4.5 goals a game, and Butler, a team that averages giving up over 3 goals a game. And it's how you're playing at the end of the season, Don, and Butler is playing fantastic.
Madure comes way out of his net again to play a puck in his own zone, plays it up, and Barnes has it into the Butler zone. Barnes goes wide right wing, bad angle shot, hit the side of the cage. Now it comes, look out, big slap shot, save is made, rebound, oh, just knocked wide. Was Peters Township Zach Gilarowski as he came in from the left point. Gilarowski has it again, center point, skates in, goes backhander, and he missed the net. Now the defenseman for Peters taking some chances. We saw Ekberg do that earlier.
And they're really motoring now. They know 2-0, 6 minutes to go. All is not lost. Keep playing hard. You could get one by him. Could change the tone of this game. But they're really skating hard right now and going for it.
Gilarowski again into the zone. Left wing side. Good wrist shot. Backwood with the save. Boy, they are throwing everything at him. Here comes Butler, 2-on-1. Ackleson shoots it wide as he ignored Martin coming down the slot. Martin has it now for the Golden Tornado. Martin wrist shot it. He shot it wide. Good job by Butler to keep it into the zone. Unable to pull the trigger. Seth Queen coming late down the slot. Ackleson, good pressure by Ackleson and Martin on this line. Now, look out. Here comes Adam Alani. In one goal. He shoots. He scores. Adam Alavi, a great move around the defenseman, stuck it between the pads of Clay Bachman and the Indians on the scoreboard.
Alavi came down, we've seen him try this before, but he came down with a ton of speed, got in between the defenseman, made a left-right move, and put it in between. I think he went 5-0 on Bachman. Adam Alavi is extremely skilled, and that is a tremendous goal, and now down 2-1 with 5:26. That 2-0 didn't hold up very long, Don.
Just used great quickness to get around the Butler defender, and then he just had a small opening. And here come the Indians. Penalty coming up against Peters Township.
Oh my goodness, that's interference, and that's a good call. The man didn't have the puck. He was going for the puck. That's a great call by the referee. I give them credit for calling that. They can complain all they want, but that's a good call. You can't interfere with a man. He doesn't have the puck. And that is a very good call by the referee. Now I was just going to say, can Butler now withstand this? Peters Township's got life now. They know they can score on Bach when they beat him. The question becomes, can Peters Township keep up the offense? Can they keep putting pucks on net? And can Butler clear the puck? You can't keep giving them opportunities now for Butler. But they can get some offense going here and get a power play goal. Go up Peters by two again would be something big for them. Now this is their fourth power play, so now both teams even on the power plays.
Rebels the penalty. 5:09 left in regulation. Final from the PIHL Division II quarterfinals. Carrick beats Harbor Creek. 6-5. So the top seed from Class C beats the top team from Class B in the quarterfinals.
A lot of people were worried about that, and I told a couple of people how good Carrick is. They are strong.
Farrow, the man advantage for Butler, shot maybe a piece of it by Madure with the blocker glove. Back behind the Peters Township net, Gilliland leaves it for Scott. Scott goes to the right point to Fair. Left point to Davis. Davis just innocently throws it behind the net, takes a big hit. Gilliland can't keep it in. Peters clears. On the chase is Emilio for Peters Township. He is held up. Now he's killing precious time back behind the Butler net. He's knocked off his skates, falls in the puck. He's doing whatever he can to be a one-man gang and kill this penalty.
I saw Carrick play last week, and they are tremendous. I've seen Harbor Creek, too. Basically, we're talking about it last night. If they could keep Carrick down to three or four goals, Harbor Creek's going to win the game. But Carrick gets out there and scores five or six goals. Look out, but it's a 6-5 game. Harbor Creek usually doesn't score that many goals, but their team is something special. 8 or 9 seniors. They got a good shot now to win the Division II championship.
They called the faceoff outside the Butler zone. Barnes takes it in, but an offside call against the Indians. 58 seconds left on the Butler power play. Down to 4:17.
And Peters Township very, very good on the penalty kill. Olavi's out there. They're looking for offense. Galarowski out there. Barnes, they're not afraid to go for it. 4-on-5.
Shorthanded shot from the right side by Peters Township's Carter Ekberg got knocked down. Ooh. Dangerous pass in front of the Butler net. Stolen. Barnes has it. Throws it in front of the doorstep. Kicked aside by Bachman.
Wow.
Here come the Golden Tornadoes. Martin back. Goes left wing side to Ben Rogers. Rogers throws it behind the net. And Butler's got a chance here to get that third goal, and it looks like they're very passive with the man advantage.
I was thinking the same exact thing. They're not aggressive. It looks like they're almost scared to make a mistake.
Look out, Olavi almost got a chance coming down the left wing side. Now Martin for Butler. He gets around Barnes. Martin with it. Martin fires, and wrist shot goes wide. 2 seconds left. Man advantage is now over. Here comes Emilio for Peters Township down the left wing side, trying to control bouncing puck. Throws it in front. Lane puck is loose. Backman gloves it out of midair as Ramholz from the penalty box skated right in front of the net. Got a piece of the centering pass, and Backman says no.
Wow. I mean, right in front, he's 5 feet in front, and Bachman almost reached behind himself to glove it. He kind of came from behind himself. I keep writing things down, and someone's going to call a timeout here. I think it's Peter Township. I keep writing things down, what could be the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena play of the game. I've jotted a few things down. Olavi's goal, goal for Butler, but that may be it now. Every time I turn around, he's making a big save. And I go back to what me and you talked to Patrick Perrimans earlier, and he said nothing phases Bachman. These kids play behind him. They play for him. He's a leader, and a lot of times your goalie's not your leader, but, boy, I tell you what, Bachman has just been fantastic. The shots have to be nearing mid-40s by now for Peters Township. You pointed out earlier, they're throwing everything at him, backhands, forehands, coming in on the rush, slap shots from the point. Pucks from the corner, pucks through the crease. A couple of shaky moments. But right now, if they win this game, he's the number one star. There's no doubt about it. And he has carried this team. And he is 3 minutes and 4 seconds away from a finals berth. I got to tell you. And they're there talking to him now. Butler, they're done. They're right over. And they still only have four. Oh, they have 5 guys out there. Okay. Talking to their goaltender. He's talking back to them. Good communication between them.
Face-off to the right of Bachman, won by Peters Township. Gilarowski goes along the near side. Quick shot, hit a skate, and the rebound went sailing through the goal mouth. First shot by Olavi. Butler trying to get it out of their zone. In front, Barnes can't tee it up. Comes to Ekberg. Ekberg fires on goal, and Bachman may have got a piece of it or it hit a body. Goes to the far side. Rogers has it off the boards and down.
Boy, it seems like Olavi, Galarowski, Cochran, they've been out there every other shift.
Galarowski to Olavi. Down the left wing side, leaves it for Cochran. Cochran goes center point. Look out. Broken up. by Ackleson. He almost had a breakaway if he'd have been able to dig that puck from Ekberg's skates.
How fast did Gilroski go back there to get that puck?
2:15 left. Ackleson with a shot, and Madore with a good blocker glove save as Ackleson fought his way to a good opportunity there. Almost another one. Boy, Ackleson has come on strong here in this third period.
Penalty?
And we got a penalty coming
up.
Oh,
my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Oh, that's tough. That's a check into the boards as the puck is going by him. Are they called interference on that? Oh, Don, that's a tough call at that point in the game. I mean, the puck's there. The player's there. They collide. It's a good check as the puck goes down. And they're not happy. That's a tough call, Don. It's not like the puck was behind the net and he's holding them on the boards.
This official.
That's a tough one. He's taking the majority of the call.
What is that, 10 penalties now?
That's nine penalties.
He's made 8 of the 9. I'm not saying that's good or bad. I'm just stating a fact.
That's a tough one. He's trying to explain it to the Butler coach now. I don't like it. Again, if the puck is 6 seconds by them and it's in the corner and you're holding them up, that's one thing. But the puck's just by him, and you collide and check. I don't think he held them there that long. That's a tough one. That's a judgment call. You usually don't see referees making that call. Although he's made some good calls tonight, that's not his best.
Exactly. 2 minutes left.
The Butler penalty number 19.
Shot from the right point by Ekberg goes off the glass behind the net. Remember now, Butler can't ice the puck.
And they can call timeout too.
We'll watch. Madore is still in the net, and that's a good thing because pass to Olivi to the left point went sailing by him. Now Olivi has it for Peters Township after the Madore save. His shot blocked on, comes to the right point. Ekberg looking. His pass picked off. Gross has it. He'll send it all the way down into the Peters zone.
How long do you wait if you're Rick Tingle to bring the goalie out at 1:27 now?
I would be close to now.
Right about now, I would say.
But once they get it in deep, if they can't get it in deep, Gilarowski has it to Olivi. Olivi into the zone to Gilarowski. Gilarowski goes to Ekberg.
Here it comes.
Shot. Oh, hit the outside of the post. Now whistle blows. I think they're going to say that.
Net off the moorings. Yep.
That puck was hit so hard. Well, the puck did knock it off, but nonetheless.
Matt Emilio comes on.
Where's the faceoff? Here's the question.
Commodore comes off. 1:02 remaining, both in the period and on the penalty. I thought the penalty was over the two-minute mark. That's interesting.
No, it was right at the exact same time. Yep.
Madore
out. Gilarowski shot blocked. Loose in front. Puck is down. Goalie down. Whistle blows. Bogman was down on his belly, but Peters Township could not get it by him. And the officials blow the whistle. Face off in the Butler zone with 55 seconds left.
Boy, they are withstanding it.
So it is power play time the rest of the way. And now Butler will get their timeout. Give Clay Bachman a chance to maybe catch his breath.
I got to tell you, man, he has seen everything, only the one, and it took a fantastic move by a great offensive player to split two defensemen to beat him one-on-one. You can't blame him for that one. Has he been lucky a couple of times, shot, hitting him? Yeah, but he has been there every time. If he sees it, Butler's got to get a couple clears here. You can't have 6-on-4 for 55 seconds in the zone. I'm not going to say Butler's been outplayed.
Well, you got to be told if you're Pat Hammonds, you got to be telling the troops, you get the puck, you go for the net.
Yeah.
Just make sure it clears out of the zone, but get it down on goal because, again, you're shorthanded, so you can't be whistled for icing. So
exactly.
You can take those length of the ice shots to the open cage.
And another thing, too, is Butler's defense diving, getting in front of pucks, trying to – I give their forwards all the credit in the world. They're coming up on the defense, trying to limit Gilarowski and Ekberg.
And that's good, but you know what? All it takes is one fake. That kid goes sliding out of position.
We saw that as Gilarowski went around a man about a minute and a half ago.
Face off to the left of Bachman.
Well, Butler needs a face off win bad.
One by Butler. In the corner, Gross really didn't want to do anything with it except tie it up.
Yeah, interesting.
Ekberg, Gilarowski fires in the stick save by Bachman. Gilarowski again from the left point. Works it on the near boards. It's poked out by Fair. Look out, empty net! Score! Connor Scott! Backhand into the open net. It's not over yet, but Butler leads 3-1.
Well, I gotta tell you what, that some Peters Township people are getting out of their seats and walking out. Down two, they still got a power play. You can't give up on your team, the Butler crowd. The yes chant.
Now, Medour, after the goal, came back into the pipes. And right before they dropped the puck, Rick Tingle brings them off. Cochran pushes it ahead. So empty net to our right. 25 seconds left. Alevi will make some move around the man. Alevi in a goal, shot block. Rebound pushes it over behind the cage. Now it comes to the far or the near corner. Gilarowski has to cheat in. Gets it to Cochran. His shot blocked. Butler fans count it down. For the first time ever, they are one win away from a PIHL Penguins Cup championship. And Bachman, as you would guess, mobbed by his teammates. And somehow he escaped the mob. Did you see that? They had the goal pinned to the boards. And yet somehow he escaped them all. He truly is a magician. And we will have a new AAA champion as the defending champs are eliminated here in the semifinals. So not a good night for the favorites. Both the number one seed and the number two seed eliminated.
Right, this is why we do this. And even their coaching staff is getting the crowd up as the coaches are wiping away tears. This is a big game for their program. And they shake hands right now. A tremendous game. Peter Stanton, we'll get the official stats. But, oh, I got to tell you, they threw everything at them. And now they're going to come over to the fans. We're going to try to get a picture of that as well. Boy, I tell you what, Butler with a big, big win tonight.
Our post-game show is coming up. The final score from RMU, the Butler Golden Tornado 3, the Peters Township Indians 1. It's the PIHL Penguin Cup semifinals, sponsored by Chip Toto Media here on the MSA Sports Network.
What you want is to stay warm this winter by logging on to www.msasports.net each and every day. We have all the schedules, the scores, the rankings, and the standings of the high school winter sports, plus weekly shows like Inside the WPIL Wrestling Circle, the PIHL Power Play Show, and the WPIL Round Ball Report, along with live and archive broadcasts of whatever your favorite high school sport is. Anytime, anywhere, always there, every day this winter. It's the MSA Sports Network.
UPMC Sports Medicine is the region's largest and most experienced center dedicated to caring for athletes of all levels. And as we celebrate more than 25 years of world-class care, we're proud to offer more services, have more physicians, and treat more student athletes than any other sports medicine provider in the region. Why would you choose to go anywhere else? To learn more, call 1-855-93-SPORT or visit upmcsportsmedicine.com.
Attention all teenagers in the South Hills. If you need something to do on a Friday night, look no further than the TGIF Skate at the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena. Featuring a live DJ, big screen TV, special effects lighting, and games from 8 to 11, it's the place to be this winter. Mount Lebanon Ice Arena also offers an after-school skate for younger children, Fridays from 4:30 to 6 p.m., and a full range of instructional programs for all ages. For more information, call 412-561-4363 or visit mountlebanon.org.
It's cold outside and dark way too early. That must mean one thing. It's wrestling season. With the mats rolled out in a gymnasium near you, be sure to tune in to Inside of the PIHL Wrestling Circle, Monday nights at 7 p.m. on the MSA Sports Network.
We'll provide all the scores from around the WPIL, focus on key matches, talk to coaches about their season, and provide in-depth analysis that you can't find anywhere else.
So cozy up around the fire and tune in to Inside of the PIHL Wrestling Circle every Monday night at 7 p.m. on the MSA Sports Network.
Well, that's why they play the games. Number one and number two fall here tonight. Earlier, Cannon McMillan ousting number one North Allegheny 7-0. And in a much closer contest, number two and defending champion Peters Township loses to Butler 3-1. Butler's first trip to the Pentland Cup Championships. And it was a very emotional Pat Hammonds coming off the ice, tears streaming down his face.
Yeah, I mean, you know what? No matter what happens on Saturday, they're going to remember this night. I mean, a night that they got outshot 2-1, 47-23, a night where they withstood Peters Township's onslaught not once, not twice, three times a period. It just seemed like they would come in droves, control the puck. A minute, sometimes two, to get four, five, six cracks at it. But their goaltender, Clay Bachman, stood up and saved them all except one. And his Butler team got the goals they needed, took advantage when Peters Township made mistakes. No power play goals for either team as we move into the Blade Runners scoring summary. Blade Runners is at two locations in Warrendale and Harmerville. Neither team would score on the power play. Peters Township 0 for 5. They did have 47 shots. Butler 0 for 4. They had only 23 shots, 8 of them in the third period, their best period. This game started, and it was slow for both teams. Finally, we got a score at 15-16 of the first period as Connor Scott from Butler scored to make it 1-0. Dustin Davis and Jonathan Fair on the assist. 1-0 into period number 2, no scoring. And after two periods, they were getting outshot 32-15, and that held through every period, 2-1. Advantage. Finally, in the third period at 9:34, Butler would make it 2-0, and it looked like, well, man, maybe this game could be over. Benjamin Rogers scores, Seth Queen and Marcus McCall, guys you don't hear a lot of called a lot, scored. Queen and McCall with the assist. Rogers go at 9:34, but Peters Township after that came on strong. And 11:34, Adam Alevi scores a highlight goal. He comes skating down the center of the ice, goes through the blue line, through two defensemen, has enough room, makes a left-right move, and puts the puck back past Clay Bachman in the five hole. A tremendous goal by Alevi, and at the time, it was looking like might be one of the plays of the game candidates. It's 2-1, and then Peters Township keeps putting on the charge. They keep coming in droves, and they draw a penalty, and the last 2 minutes of the game, it was 5-on-4. They pull the goaltender for the last minute, 6-on-4, and finally Connor Scott scores shorthanded, empty net, assisted by Jonathan Fair at 16:25 to make it 3-1. Jonathan Fair with two assists, Connor Scott with two goals, McQueen and McCall with an assist each, and Alevi with a goal, and Barnes with an assist. That is your scoring recap.
sponsored by Blade Runners. In two locations at Warrendale and Harmonville.
Ma Lebanon Ice Arena, play of the game, and our Management Science Associates, three stars of the game. Coming up, final again, the Butler Golden Tornado 3, the Peters Township Indians 1. You're watching and listening to the Penwood Cup semifinal sponsored by Trim Total Media here on the MSA Sports Network.
Life is about having the confidence to know you can do anything, right? I get that at Carlo.
I graduated with top awards, but beyond the classroom, Carlo helped me learn a lot about myself.
Carlo brings out the best in you.
I know I'm going to be a fantastic nurse.
I know whatever I come across, I'll be prepared.
I can't think of a better place to start the rest of my life, because at Carlo, I know I matter.
I matter.
I matter.
Enroll at Carlo University, visit carlo.edu.
When looking to replace your athletic field, choose ProGrass, first in turf. ProGrass has installed over 500 fields in the U.S. Getting the best artificial turf for your field depends upon both the product and the partner you choose. That's why architects, athletic directors, and players choose the ProGrass Performance System. ProGrass maintains an active presence in the field turf industry as members of the Sports Turf Management Association and the American Sports Builder Association, and is proud to be recognized as a FIFA preferred manufacturer. Call ProGrass today at 866-270-6003 or visit them on the web at www.prograssturf.com. ProGrass, first in turf.
Want to learn how to ice skate or play hockey like they do in the PIHL? Looking for a good place to throw that winter birthday party? If you answered yes, Blade Runners is the place to go for public or private skating sessions, plus learn to skate and learn to play hockey classes. And don't forget to check out PIHL game action at their two locations in Harmerville and Warrendale. For more information on ice time, class and game schedules, or party planning, visit their website at www.bladerunnersice.com. See you at the rink.
The new home for the PIHL in 2014-2015 is the MSA Sports Network. Not only can you listen to audio broadcasts of high school hockey games online like in years past, but this year MSA Sports will be video streaming 25 games live and archived during the regular season with exclusive coverage of the 2015 Penguin Cup playoffs. Your audio and video home of the PIHL is the MSA Sports Network.
All right, back one final time here at Robert Morris University Sports Complex with Mike Azadian. I'm Don Rebel. Marvelous contest as Butler prevails 3-1 over Peters Township. We will not have a repeat defender, repeat champion in AAA. Last time that happened, 0-1-0-2 with Bethel Park. We will have a new champion. It will either be Cannon McMillan or for the first time since 2010, or Butler for the first time ever, 7-15 on Saturday.
And I can't remember the last time a four, and a, was it a 4-5 seed?
4-6.
4-6. When's the last time a
4-6
in AAA?
That is because you have bracketing, my friend.
And I like that.
Oh, I love it.
I love the bracketing now.
I've been pushing for that for years, and the reseeding, all it does is really
give the better teams the better chance.
No doubt.
Because if you upset somebody as an 8 seed, and say you upset the number one seed, and then you got to play the number two
seed.
And
in double
A,
you have a 1-4. I mean, when's the last? You didn't see. It's always 1-2s or 3s, and that might be the case in Class A, the way it plays up. But we'll find out tomorrow. We thought it might be the case here in AAA, and it was not.
I think if you're a lower seed and you upset somebody early, you should play the brackets the way it is, because you should get a benefit for upsetting somebody. The number one and the number two seed shouldn't get a benefit because a lower seed won, and then you got to play a lower seeded opponent. Maybe they got lucky once, but in Butler's case, I don't think you can say they got lucky once or twice. They earned this victory. Earned a victory against Bethel Park. Yeah, they got severely outshot and at times outplayed, but they did what they had to do to win the game.
All right, let's take a look at the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena play of the game. Mount Lebanon is the place to be for teens, the ice arena, that is, in the South Hills on Friday nights.
A little bit of a debate about it. There was a lot of different things that you could have said. I fought a little bit for the big glove save by Bachman. But you made a great point. The Benjamin Rogers goal in the third period at 9:34 to go up 2-0. If he doesn't score that goal, we still may be in overtime because Peters Township did score to make it 2-1. So the Benjamin Rogers goal at 9:34, which he backhanded and top shelfed, is the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena play of the game. Mount Lebanon Ice Arena is the place to be for teens in the South Hills.
And they just, the play, I mean, it was innocent enough. He was fighting for the puck in the corner of the Peters Township zone. And the Peters Township Indians, the puck came like it was going to come out of the zone, and the Indians went streaking toward the blue line and completely forgot about Rogers, who, and I want to say it was Fair who kept it in and pushed it toward the front of the net, knowing that there was nobody there but Rogers. And Rogers got the puck, and it was one-on-one with Madour, and a tremendous shot with a backhander up underneath the crossbar for the goal. So, yeah, I think that if Peters scores that on the Levy goal, if that's the equalizer, you know, we're either still playing or who knows what would have happened.
And another big thing, too, is the goaltending. Madour had only played four games this year. 4-0, 0.075 goals against average, .967 save percentage. Tony Lejeune played 13, and Caden Schell played 5. But Lejeune, who won in the first round, they decided to go to Madour, a kid who played only four games. He played pretty well, but that's something the coaches are going to have to go through in their mind now as Peters Township is out in the postseason.
One more order of business. The Management Science Associates, three stars of the game. Mike, you're on camera
camera?
You can talk to the camera.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was kind of looking at different things here. Number three star is Adam Alevi with the one goal, tremendous goal, individual effort, crossed through two defensemen, made a move to make the score 2-1. Your number two star for for Butler is Connor Scott with two goals. And your number one star and your player of the game, there was no doubt about this, it's Clay Bachman. 46 saves on 47 shots. Clay Bachman, the Management Science Associates, number one star of the game.
Season's over for the 2014 champion Peters Township Indians. 17-5-2 for Rick Tingle's squad. Another marvelous season, but they are unable to repeat. Instead, it's the Cinderella, and I expect there will be a lot of people from Butler County headed south to Console Energy.
Lee Moan will be there.
On Saturday. I don't know about that.
Hey, he's coming anyway.
Butler now 13-8-3, and they will be taking on Cannon McMillan. If you missed it, Cannon McMillan 7-0 over North Allegheny. So two of the three championships are set. Check out our website, msasports.net, later for the recaps of these two semifinals. Also, the latest as far as the scores through the AAA and AA semifinals. One more dual set of semifinals coming up tomorrow. Class A, 6 o'clock. Top seed and defending champion Quaker Valley against Hempfield. And at 8 o'clock, it's a pretty good matchup, 2-3, Deer Lakes against Mars. In the semifinals on in Class A tomorrow, and then all three championship games. Watch and listen, MSASports.net Saturday.
One more playoff game tomorrow night, too, as well, in the Division II playoffs, the quarterfinals. It's Peters Township.
B that's right, for all B you squad. Peters Township folks, that's right.
B squad at Indiana, and Peters Township B has played well over toward the end of the year. They are alive. The winner of that will play.
Winner of that.
Carrick plays Beaver.
I got my open here. Hold on.
Carrick plays
Not
Beaver.
Not my open. It's
Meadville.
Division two.
No, I'm sorry. Meadville plays Carrick.
Beaver. Will play Beaver. And the other semifinal now set with Carrick beating Harbor Creek. Carrick will take on Meadville. Both those semifinals are Monday. Both those can be heard and seen at msasports.net. And then the championships next Thursday here at RMU for Division II. Well, that'll do it. Thanks to JZC, who used to go by the artist formerly known as Jody Zangrilli Cook, for her help on camera here on the other side of the world from her village. And thanks to my broadcast partner, Mike Azadian, and all the folks involved from the PIHL and also from the MSA Sports Network. One more semifinal coming up tomorrow. Final score and a thriller. The Butler Golden Tornado 3, the Peters Township Indians 1.
The 2015 PIHL Penguins Cup High School Hockey Playoffs at MSASports.net have been sponsored by the Mount Lebanon Ice Arena, by Blade Runners, by S-Mark, by First Commonwealth Bank, by Carlo University, by UPMC Sports Medicine, by ProGrass, and by Management Science Associates. Follow the PIHL Penguin Cup playoffs all the way through the state championships by logging on every day to www.msasports.net. The preceding has been an exclusive presentation of the Management Science Associates Sports Network.